The Loire welcome you, and so do I. I'm counting on you to stick with me. You think Marcon is gonna roll up and beg you to put a bullet in his brain? Get that motherfucker.
Richie not to put Charlie in charge of the heroin, but he said he owed Charlie's old man or some shit.
Charlie ain't half the man his pop was, shit.
When that nigger shows his face around here, we'll deal with him. And then deal with Charlie.
Long enough to raise your family.
Okay, sure thing. Whatever you want.
That's good, Charlie. Real good.
Send your men to the First Baptist Church. Those Dixie heathens have been handled.
I'll have some of my men come right over. And thanks.
State your name for the record.
Donovan. John.
Mr. Donovan, you understand that by appearing before this committee, you have explicitly waived your constitutional rights in regards to counsel and self-incrimination.
Sure.
And you further acknowledge that by appearing before this committee, you agree to disclose all information pertaining to the events that occurred in New Bordeaux during the summer and fall of 1968.
I wouldn't be sitting here if I didn't.
You were an operative in the Central Intelligence Agency from 1953 to 1969, is that correct?
That's right.
When did you arrive in Vietnam?
August of 1961.
Please describe for this committee the actions you took during your time in Vietnam.
I spent a couple months in Saigon. Then I was transferred to a base in Laos that was operated by the Special Activities Division. We trained and equipped the Hmong and then turned them loose on the NVA. We're running arms and supplies via the Ho Chi Minh Trail.
And you worked with Lincoln Clay in what eventually became the Phoenix Program.
Within a year or so, Lincoln was heading up his own PRU. We'd cross over into Vietnam and locate enemy targets and either kill them or bring them back for interrogation. Just thinking about it? Jesus Christ. You wouldn't believe the shit we did to those cocksuckers.
We're cleaning this place up right, thanks to you. Beaumont Taillet.
This man's name is Jesse. We were just having ourselves a little conversation about Richie Doucet.
Listen, I ain't done nothing, you hear? I don't know anything. I was just taking a walk and walking down the street and she just grabbed me is all.
You with Dixie Mafia?
No. Yes. I mean, shit. I did it for the money, you hear? I ain't got nothing personal against y'all. I don't even carry a gun.
Where's Doucet?
He's out at the abandoned amusement park to the west of here.
Banned Saturdays? What the hell is he doing out there?
From what I heard, it's because you've been tearing things up. Georgie's on a goddamn warpath. He wants Richie dead. So Richie, he grabbed what was left of the heroin and took off. Said he was gonna lay low until he could settle things with Georgie.
How many men he got with him?
Hell, I don't know. All of them.
Hand me that knife.
No, no, please. No, I ain't done nothing to y'all. Please, I'm begging you. My mama, my papa.
Go on, get.
He could want to sit.
He ain't no threat to nobody. Let him run back home to his mama.
If you wrong, there'll be hell to pay.
I got a bad sense about this man. Richie needs to work his shit out with Georgie.
Huh?
Hey, motherfucker!
Welcome to Baron Saturday's Fun Park. We're sure happy to have you with us today. So put your troubles aside and enjoy yourself. You never know what that dirty old Baron's got waiting for you round the corner.
Thank you.
is over.
Ducking down!
So, he's gone?
I think they went back to that spot.
Search every goddamn corner till we find them.
Now on your right, we got the Carnival Carousel. Nice place for you boys and girls to stay out of trouble. But if you're one of those adventurous types, you might want to head over and meet the meanest gators this side of the bayou on the crazy gator roller coaster.
Ducking.
You're dead, cocksucker!
Huh?
We in it now, y'all. I'll find him and pound him.
Is this George's boys. This would George.
Oh, motherfucker. Buy me some time.
I'll be over here.
Must have found his sense.
Hey, motherfucker! We know you're out here somewhere! Show yourself!
Come on out!
Who's got shells?
sucker!
Father Michael. The Lord called Father.
village is ran far from the beast's vicious screams. Father Michael ran toward her. Determine now whether it
must have been all along.
You're still here?
Only
ain't
one
that good.
Survived that night.
I ain't giving up that easy.
Guidance of Father Michael. The villagers cast off their heathen faith.
No point looking here anymore.
Faded into a distant memory.
You sent over a nigga to do his dirty work.
Or so they thought.
This dude, boy. You think you can come in here and steal my heroin without nobody noticing?
I'm not here to steal your heroin, Richie. I'm here to make you pay for what you did to Sammy and Ellis Robinson.
I didn't have nothing to do with it!
I watched you stab Ellis in the gut. I couldn't do nothing about it then, but I sure as hell can now.
God damn it. None of that was my idea, you hear? It was all Georgie, him and his old man. They wanted y'all gone, not me. What was I supposed to do? Say no?
Either that or make sure that I was dead.
Oh, no, no, no. No, please. Please. Listen. Listen. Just decent thing would be to let a man get in a prayer before you kill him.
You can pray on the way up.
When I saw Richie Doucette hanging from that Ferris wheel, I felt a profound sense of disbelief. Nothing like this had ever happened before. You mobsters killed each other all the time, but it was generally a small, contained event. Some greaseball is eating spaghetti and meatballs at his favorite restaurant and gets popped in the head. But this was different. Even then, even before I knew who killed him, I knew that Richie had been put on display. Lincoln was trained in psychological warfare by the CIA. He wanted to terrify the mob, wanted them to know he was going to kill every last one of them, and that none of them would be able to stop him.
Hey.
How you doing?
Seth's dead. The Hollow's yours.
They say you strung him up on the old Ferris wheel.
He killed Ellis. Shit all over the people in this neighborhood. Doucette got what he deserved.
The righteous will rejoice when he sees the vengeance. He will bathe his feet in the blood of the wicked. That goes both ways, you know.
Thought you said all that was behind us.
My men are struggling with the notion that we now have to answer to the same men who killed Baca, who wiped out half our number.
If I was them, I'd get over it. We don't have time to go around coddling people.
Of course not. But gestures carry weight. And if you were to help my man Emmanuel, that's a gesture that would go a long way in calming nerves.
What's he need?
He oversees my reefer operation over at the boathouse. Help him, and I'll see to it you get a portion of the profits.
Just so we're clear, I'm expecting a cut of everything, not just what comes from selling weed. It's gonna cost a lot of money to take down Marcano.
Don't worry. I'll make sure you get your money.
Breaking news in New Bordeaux. There are reports of a violent shootout at the abandoned Baron Saturday's fun park. The authorities haven't released an official tally, but sources are reporting multiple casualties. One witness claims to have seen a man hanging from the very top of the decommissioned Ferris wheel, but police have refused to comment on the veracity of that report. The fun park has been closed for a number of years and was once a subject of controversy for what colored civil rights groups described as racially inflammatory imagery.
You want to buy something? You need to talk to Cassandra.
She said you could use some help, assuming you're Emmanuel.
Assume at your own risk, Lincoln Clay.
So running the weed, y'all got a routine laid out?
We take a boat to the bayou, grab the bears, bring them back.
Bayou can be a rough territory. Dixie Mafia knows every inch.
Did those white boys scare you, Frey? Did they touch your zozo when you were a child?
Cassandra failed to mention your charming personality.
I highly doubt she forgot.
You do this kind of thing back in Haiti?
Back in my country, I was a hoogan, a priest.
What's a priest know about trafficking weed?
I did not run marijuana, Frey. My cargo was refugees, people. I saved their lives, got them away from Duvalier. But you probably don't know much about that.
We gonna have a problem, you and me?
Cassandra says we are partners, that everything is cool between us. Are we cool?
Don't think I call it that.
Neither would I. Cassandra might be able to let go of what you did to our people, but I cannot.
Maybe you'd be happier back in Haiti.
It was not my choice to come here, leave my home. But I'm trying to make the best of it.
Aren't we all?
There are still Dixie Mafia scattered around the hollow. If you have the time, you should see to them. Convince them to leave.
A shipment of weed is being delivered down in Cassandra. Never opened up to me about her own history. As much as I tried to be an ear when she needed to talk.
Cleaning this place up right, thanks to you.
Oh, that I am. Remy Duvall, that is. Welcome to the Native Son, dear listener.
And this segment, I am joined by the lovely Miss Olivia Marconi.
Hey, everyone.
Dear listener, some of you know.
Come on.
Problems?
This goddamn thing keeps jamming up. If you're ready to see the other briefings, we can get started.
Show me what else you managed to dig up.
You got it. Two of the city's finest scumbags. Oh, yes. Point for Dunn's favorite son, Thomas Burke.
How's he doing since Danny?
9 weeks ago, Burke stumbles into Roman the Butcher Barbieri's deli, drunk off his ass, waving a gun around. He fires off 10 rounds, but the only thing he manages to hit is a fucking ham hock in the goddamn deli case. The butcher's boys slap the shit out of him and toss him in a dumpster.
Barbieri's the one who took over Point for Dunn, right? Busted up Burke's leg with a tire iron.
That's why Burke was willing to go along with the robbery. He thought he'd make things square with Sal, and he'd be able to get Point for Dunn back.
He always struck me as an asshole.
Yeah, just like every other Irishman. But he hates Marcano as much as you do.
Yeah, all right. Least I can do is give Danny's old man a chance for a little payback. Oh, fucking hell.
He's been spending his time in a dive bar up in Point for Dunn. Duffy's, it's called. Shouldn't be too hard to find.
Yo, you better be worth all this trouble.
The man himself, Mr. Vito Scaletta.
You gotta be shitting me.
Last couple months have been pretty tough on old Vito. Sal's always hated him. Thought he was a mole for the commission, but he couldn't do anything about it because Vito's maid. After the heist, Sal refused to pay Vito his cut. And then he put the clamps on him. He's been trying to limit Vito's ability to pay what's owed.
And if Scaletta can't kick up, the commissioner gave Marcano permission to whack him.
The only reason that Vito is still above ground is because he has a couple off-the-record businesses. He's been using that money to pay Sal.
Gotta give Scaletta credit. Pretty goddamn tenacious.
He's lasted a lot longer than I thought he would, but the clock is ticking. A couple weeks ago, Sal sent in his nephew, a kid named Michael Greco, to help Vito run River Row. Greco's been using his guys to limit what Vito can do, where he can go. Once he has Vito completely boxed in, he'll make his move.
Scaletta has to know what Greco has planned. I'll pay him a visit. See if I can't leverage this thing with Greco to bring Scaletta around to my way of thinking.
I'm sure I'll appreciate your concern.
You better reach out to Vito before Sal finds an excuse.
To dump him in the swamp.
Oh, watch yourself around my files. There's a system.
Thank you.
got weed on our mind. And we wondered how a little old plant could cause such a stud to be made illegal. And what were the motivations of those who drove it to be made illegal in the first place? Well, New Bordeaux has a long, proud tradition of cultivating our own vices. Making our own cigars and alcohol since, well, just before this city even existed. But of course, if the government doesn't get its cut, well, then you got trouble. So why not legalize and tax it? Is there something else going on here? Well, there's a person who might be able to shine a light on things. There are 100,000 total marijuana smokers in the U.S. And most are Negroes, Hispanics, Filipinos, and entertainers. Their satanic music, jazz, and swing result from marijuana use. This marijuana causes white women to seek...
Any word about how it's going in there?
How you think? Vito's taking his beating. Wish Greco would just let us kill a poor son of a bitch. Get it over with.
Nah, Greco wants to show how tough he is. Beat on old Vito till we all respect him.
If only all it took was beating up on a bagger. Huh?
Got it! Over here!
It's like Christmas.
Take your cover! Kill one of our boys!
Come get me, boy!
Get behind him! He's all yours, boys!
Fucking dropping us!
Where'd that fuck go?
You want to check over there?
Let's look this way.
Shit, you got
somebody here?
I think we got a situation. No,
stop looking.
Huh?
What?
Ozone fish ain't breathing!
Ozone fish ain't breathing!
No! Fucker hit me!
Fire! Fire it now!
I got the front!
Guess we put the fear of God in him.
Damn, get him!
Down, man!
Looks like I got here just in time, Vito.
Lincoln. How's this possible? I thought you were dead.
Bullet was deflected by my skull. Came out the back.
Talk about some goddamn luck.
Worst place to shoot a fella is in the forehead. Skull's harder than you think. Come on. We need to have a talk.
When I heard about what happened, I went to Marcano asking my cut right then and there. Figured if he fucked you and Sammy, I'd be next.
Yeah, I'm guessing he didn't go for it.
Said he wanted to wait for the heat to die down. Didn't want me running around, buying expensive shit, getting noticed. Like I'm some fucking amateur, never sat on a big score before. The money I fronted for the robbery was pretty much everything I put away. Didn't have enough to run, so I stayed. The commission wouldn't let him just kill me, so I figure I'd make that cocksucker jump through every hoop, make him prove I deserve to get whacked. It wasn't much, but it was something.
Heard he brought in his nephew to push you out.
A kid named Michael Greco. Nephew by marriage, not blood.
Sure didn't number in here.
Yeah. They were looking to see what other rackets I was running. I could leave a fucking paper trail in my office. Nah, don't bother with that shit. Look, appreciate you getting me out of the freezer and all, but, what are you doing here?
Marcano deserves to pay for what he did, so I'm going after him. Him, his brothers, his lieutenants, all of them. And I'm gonna need your help.
Look, you pretty much whittled me down to nothing. I mean, this is it.
For now, maybe. Once I take back River Road from Greco, money will start coming in, it'll be a different story.
Well, so we're partners now.
As long as you do what I say and give me what I want when I want.
So goodbye, Marcano. Hello, Lincoln Clay.
It's either that or more of this. And next time, I won't be around to fish your ass out the freezer.
Nobody kills that scumbag but me. You bring me Greco, I'm in.
Tell me about his rackets.
He took over the dock union, and he's got a warehouse. He has a lot of valuable shit in there. You take both of them out, Greco's finished. A couple of my guys been keeping tabs on him. You should talk to them. They'll fill you in.
All right. Vito says you can help me get this bread of mine to a safe place.
Sure can, honey. And a friend of Vito's is a friend of mine. Be there lickety-split.
All right. What are we handling today?
One heart, like ours, me.
Keep this safe.
Bonsoir, chef.
Can I get a resupply on River Road?
Be out directly.
Everything you see is for sale.
Show me what you got.
Don't. I'm out of here.
In Berkeley, California, students for a democratic society held a mass gathering demanding the disarmament of all police forces. At one point, a long-haired young man threw off a towel and danced naked for several minutes before he was persuaded by the police to replace the towel.
Some 3-foot gator that's not even fit to eat. No thank you.
Oh, sorry.
Oop. My fault.
Vito says you're reliable.
Vito said you'd be expecting me.
Took you long enough. I'm Jock Blanchard. Vito claims you can unfug this mess and get us working men back on a job.
Maybe. Depends if your information's any good.
Used to kick up to Vito's men, Andy Toretto, for union work. But now that Coyon Greco got Andy squeezing everybody for more dues. You don't pay, you don't get a work permit. Poor fucks even gotta use Greco's loudmouth buddies to collect.
This Greco sounds like a real piece of shit.
You don't know the half of it. On top of that, Andy's gotta keep the permits under lock and key. Anything happens to those, oof. Ain't no work happening around here.
I'll see what I can get out of Toretto's people.
Toretto runs a tight ship, but you should be able to get some of his guys talking.
Hallelujah. Have no doubt, friend. God is good.
Brothers mixing it up with white women. In for trouble. But they're abandoning the community that raised them.
Just thank you.
Hey man, just got shot.
Greco.
Go, go, go!
Says I ain't quitting shit, but if I was serious about it...
Motherfuckers need to wait your turn.
You know, bust the hell out of them. Try
to shut that man down.
I told him there was a misunderstanding.
Next time, keep your damn mouth shut.
Leave some for me.
Over here, he's
surprise, motherfucker.
after the cocksucker that this week's been, a little hunting and drinking with the boys will fix what ails me.
If you live off.
Is that the only one who writes that?
Got him. Head right.